Hello, people of St. Timothy's. I'm Kathy Sullivan, and I'm the Director of Administration and Finance for the parish. As I was getting ready for this talk, it was a Sunday morning where the reading happened to be one of my favorites. And it particularly hit home this year in 2020 in the state of COVID, because I think this reading is so much more about being fed or being hungry as far as physically. I think it has much more to do about our faith life and what our God means to us, as well as what our church means to us. It's from Philippians chapter 4. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things through Him who gives me strength. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accordance with His glorious riches in Jesus Christ. To say 2020 has been a challenge is quite an understatement, as we all know. As the administrator here, there have been many moments where I have longed for that manual on how to manage a pandemic in a church. There are no written policies. There are no written procedures. They've been coming up with them as things change here in this world. I think back to March 21st. It was a Saturday morning when our finance committee met along with a representative of our pastoral council and our two trustees and Father Joe and I. And I remember the big giant circle we had going in room 224 here in the parish office, and how odd it seemed, the social distancing and the wearing of masks and disinfecting. It was just so foreign to us, and things that have become second nature to each of us. But at that meeting, we were concerned. We were all greatly concerned about St. Timothy's. We knew this pandemic could be very financially devastating to this church. We planned and talked about how we can work with a very low income coming in. We implemented a spending freeze. Nothing was spent that wasn't absolutely necessary from that point on. But we made a commitment first and foremost that we would always pay our bills that needed to be paid, and that we would keep our regularly scheduled staff employed as long as we possibly could. Consequently, we decided to buy or get a PPP loan through the Small Business Administration. That PPP loan was a godsend. It paid our salaries for 5 payroll periods here at St. Tim's. Shortly after that meeting, we closed the office and we all adjusted to a new world of working at home. Parishioners adjusted to leaving messages for staff and knowing they would get a phone call. And right around that time, we sent out an appeal letter to our parishioners. It is with deepest gratitude that I express, that I can't express enough, your overwhelming support that came through that appeal letter. Not only physically written letters of support to the staff, but financial support. We had an Easter collection that was higher than any since I've been there, and we didn't even have masses. But many of you have been asking, really, how is the church doing? How are we doing? Do we have enough? So I'd like to let you know that first and foremost, our annual report is available to all of you currently on our website to view. It is also available if you would like a hard copy. Just call the parish office and we will mail one out to you. It will give you the details on all of our finances for the previous fiscal year, which ran from July 2019 until June 2020. But I will tell you that it will show a significant surplus in income and in our bottom line. And much of that is thanks to many of you who responded to our appeal in April and in May, and many of you who gave your entire year's worth of donations at that time. And we are going to be using those donations this coming year, because currently our budget for this fiscal year shows a significant deficit, as you will see in the annual report. We budget it very conservatively. There's no choice when you have a world that is so uncertain but to budget extremely conservatively. We also know that outside of that operational budget, we have some very major expenses coming. We have a temperature control system, as well as air exchangers in the parish office. that a number of experts have told us need to have work done and need to be replaced. We would really like to get to the point where we can live stream things here in this church and to upgrade our camera systems to do so. Our parking lot this spring will be due for a resurfacing. It is time to do a full resurface of that parking lot to keep it properly maintained. And we've heard rumors we're going to be getting a fairly large assessment from the city for curb repair and replacement along both the east and the north sides of our entire campus. Always present, of course, is this church boiler, our church boiler that could go at any time, as well as that ever-present repair that will need to be done to the arches of our hospitality center. But we do know that we will most likely need to dip into our reserves at some point here this year, but we are fortunate to have reserves and to not have debt to worry about. Our theme for our annual pledge drive this year says, uncertain times, uncertain world, unshaken faith, and a hope-filled future. We continue here at St. Timothy's to do God's work through these challenges. So I'm asking for your continued financial support. Soon, within the next couple weeks, you will be getting a pledge card in the mail. I ask you to fill it out and return it. And also, please do so knowing that we know this has been a difficult year for many of you. And if you can't give as much as you could last year, know that you are in your prayers, because we know you're being challenged just like we are. In closing, I want to thank first and foremost our finance committee, our pastoral council, and our trustees who have been incredibly supportive and helpful as we navigate these uncharted waters. I want to thank our staff who has navigated these things in a wonderful and stellar and professional manner. But first and foremost, and most importantly, to all of you for your support, your prayers, and your financial donations. Daily here at St. Tim's, it is an honor and a privilege for me to witness firsthand what your contributions do for the people of St. Timothy's and to our greater community. Thank you. Take care, and God bless.